Hi everyone. So I'm Philippe Echaroux. I'm a French guy from Marseille in the south of France. And today I'm here to explain you how did I started in photography from zero to today. I'm not hero at all, but from zero to today, simply. So for me, everything started in 2008. I was studying social work in France and I buy a cheap camera, and the first year I tried to subscribe to the dual photography competition, and for me it was a miracle because the same year I won it. So I was the first surprise of it, like I won this competition, it's my first year. So I think maybe, guy, you got something to do in photography, but I wanted to finish my social studies first, so this is what I did. And I started photography with portraits. As a social worker, for me it was kind of logical, and I was working with hard people, homeless in the street, and I started to do portraits of them. And at this time, if someone had told me, I would be the last guy to photograph the football legend Johan Cruyff, I would not have believed it, because it was the beginning. Thanks. Thanks. So I decided to let a chance to photography at this time, and I quickly understand that to making a job, I have to produce some image that people will know I have made this portrait without signing it. So it was the beginning of a hard work period, because I worked so hard, because I learned on my own to understand the technical aspect and the lighting stuff. And 3 years later, or 4 years later, I was doing my first worldwide campaign, advertising one for Adidas. And at this time I was so scary, because for me it was a big advertising campaign of my life, and I was like, wow. But after that, it passed well, and I was like, okay, maybe you could be a professional photographer for real. So I started to do at this time lots of celebrity portraiture, like Johnny Wilkinson, the rugby player. Sorry. This one is famous in France, not here. And this one is Sébastien Chabal. It's a French rugby player too. A very, very strong guy, 2 meters high. And my thing was to produce some portraits, strong ones, with high contrast and strong attitude. I wanted to make pictures that when you look at it, I want you to feel watched by these guys, actually. And here is another one. But when you say I'm a celebrity photographer, I think, hi. Most of the people think I'm working in a big studio with tons of assistants, and okay, it's not like this, because I will show you how it's like to be a celebrity photographer today in my experience with a little movie. I have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should.
Donc là, on est au Get a Cool Festival pour photographier Monsieur Fatboy Slim, légende de l'électro, qui va se produire sur la scène qui est juste derrière moi ici dans quelques heures. C'est comme souvent des shootings de gens très connus comme lui, ça se passe souvent en 1 minute, voire 30 secondes, donc voilà, on va falloir être prêt.
We'll be right back.
so you see a real backstage of my photographer life. When I started to work like this, I was the first surprised. I really didn't think I have 1 minute or sometimes five or maximum 10 to make a portrait. But doing this, at the beginning it was very hard and I made some mistakes. But in the end, it learned me one thing very important, and now this portrait and the other one are always made like very quickly, like 2 minutes maximum. Because for me, with the work I have done on the technical aspect, I think I don't have to think when I make a portrait of someone, and I think the important thing is that the guy in front of me don't have to think. So you have to be very quick. And that's where getting the right camera, the right gear is so important, because I have in my hand my Hasselblad camera, of course, and I'm sure this will work just fine. And all I have to be careful of is the way I speak to the guy and what is happening between me and the guy I'm photographing. I know the camera will be just fine, and that's very important, because you know, you're right with the camera, you just have to think about your picture. So let's see all the photographs made the same way you saw Fatboy Slim. Here is a Brazilian captain. And here is a guy from the same city as me, from Marseille, he's in the 99, you must know him. And for example, same thing, you will see where did I shoot it? Him, right there, in a dirty, crappy, like, places, not a big studio at all. Sorry. Selling some dreams, but sorry. We went to the rainforest lately. I will come back later to this. And this is, it was the same kind of shooting Indians. They don't really know photography. They don't, not the same as us. So you have to be quick. Here, example of the Indians we shot there. For them, some of them have never seen a camera before. Here is another funny thing, like, shooting a celebrity or a guy paid work, the guy in front of you is knowing you are making a portrait, is okay, and it's all prepared. But here is a challenge I wanted to give myself, was working in my city with a camera and asking people, can I make you a portrait? And most of the time you have to know, they say no. They say, I have no time, I don't mind, I don't want, okay. You have to be strong in your head, because if you want like 10 portraits, it will take you more than one day. So we try this in my area, in my city, with my friend. And if the guy were saying yes, he would have a little bit of surprise, you will see.
Ever leave this world alive?
Allez, c'est bon.
For the things you did in my life. If I ever leave this world alive, I'll come back down and sit beside your feet tonight. Wherever I am, you'll always be more than just a man.
So we spent like 2 days shooting people in the street like this. And here is the result of this one, especially. Here is this guy. It was very nice to give us some time. I think for a photographer, even if you're a professional and doing advertising work, it's important to give you a challenge like this, just to go out from your comfort zone. And you will, I think, learn some things doing this, even if you are saying no all the time. Yeah, all the portraits we did the same way, it was in another city, hi. And here are some portraits of the Indians we made the same way, so very quickly. It was the shaman of the village. Okay, here is the second part. So, being a photographer portrait is nice, I like that. And I consider that the photo I made the pictures with the guy or the woman in front of me. But I wanted to create something more personal, and it started with a joke. When you have appointments with art director, you show Zidane and the other celebrities, okay? but I wanted to put some impossible image of celebrities I could have photographed, but I'm 33, and for example, I never could have photographed Hendrix. And I was putting my celebrity portraits and some jokes like this, with always a little detail, you can see the hypo, on the pictures, just to see if the guy who are really looking at my pictures. We did the same with Marilyn. I wanted to show her how she would be today, or like maybe a few years ago. I really love quantum physics, and for me, if this guy was alive today, he would say maybe lol about our reality, so it was kind of a private joke, but I wanted the art director to have an appointment a little bit more fun than, okay, I do this portrait, it's great, okay. No, let's put some joke in it. After this joke, I went to something more personal. So I remember I was a social worker, and I want to give my photograph a message, a meaning. Maybe people will catch it, maybe not. But my goal was, okay, you make portraits, let's go to try another thing, and let's try something very different and difficult. Is before making the photograph, you have to know why you will do it. And that's the main part of the job and the most difficult one. So maybe people will understand something in it, maybe not. It's up to you, not to me. So here are some different examples of scenes I've created to try to say something. Another one. And this is my favorite actually, because when I was working with people in the streets, they were not kids, but adults, but that's the thing they're living. They're always thinking they will have another chance, but not so true, badly. So I made this picture for this. And this is the last one. We made that for where I live in France. It's very warm in the summer, and we had a big fire last summer. And we made these pictures to thank the fireman who helped kill this fire, because for personal example, the fire stopped like 2 kilometers from my house. So it was like very scary, and I wanted to thank them in my way with what I know to do. Okay, here is the last part. So I like making pictures, that's my thing, but I wanted to create something else, because making portraits is great, making pictures with a message, I love that, but I wanted to be more universal, and I always loved street art. So I told myself, why not try it? Why? So the way I thought that was, there are some very good graffiti guys, some other one using pasting some papers. So I told myself, if you want to be an artist, you have to create your own way of doing some street art. And after a long time of reflection, I thought, you're a photographer, your thing is the light. And why not using the light? I mean a beamer. So what you will see is a real life thing, not Photoshop, to make some street art. And moreover, the good thing that is important for me is that I don't let any clue of thing on the wall. I just do my art and I disappear. I just take a photograph to show the people. So here what it looks like. My thing is asking people questions or projecting some faces in the street. Here is actually in my city. The reflection is the same as a picture with a message. It's producing something that try to be like nice to see, but with another symbol and a reflection behind. It is something I made in La Habana, Cuba. This thing was done in the center of La Habana, Cuba, and projecting there was a very, very big challenge, because the police, and they don't really like people saying things like this in Cuba, because it's a pretty close country. It was pretty hard to do that there, but we did it, and I'm here, okay, and today I'm okay. Okay, another one, very representative of what I thought of my trip to Cuba. It was like, you're free, but maybe not. This means I write because nobody is listening. This sentence was inspired from a discussion I had with a Cuban guy. It was exactly what he was thinking. This was in a French Alps, so it's a portrait like I do, but projected on rocks and snow. And there is my grandmother. She's 95 now, and she never traveled. So I made her travel, and I show her the picture, and it made her laugh a lot. But she don't really understand what it is, I think. It was in Barcelona. Another thing in the French Alps. And it's in my city. It's a post-it with write, think of dreaming, because for me it's an important thing to share with people. And it's some of the visual I will show, I think, in 1 or 2 months. It's an Amazonian one we made in the rainforest with the Indians. I went there for this. Another one. Okay. So I wanted to thank 2 guys here. The first one is this guy there, the guy with no hair, is Charles. And the other one, I don't see him, it's Anders. And I wanted to thank them. Where is he? Okay, lad. I wanted to thank them to trust in me, to trust in young photography and artist stuff. I think it's important. So thanks a lot for listening to me. If you want to speak to me, I will stay in this area for a few moments. Bye.